Today I want to talk to you about how to draw in PatternCAD. So on the left-hand side, to be able to manipulate the nodes on your design, you're going to need to have your nodes on. That's going to be this top button on the left-hand side. It looks like it's depressed and therefore it's on. On the right-hand side, I'm on the pattern draw interface, and I'm going to start out with a line. So if I want to free motion draw, I would choose line, and I would want my node spacing to be on. That is going to be like using a stitch regulator in a way. It's going to drop nodes as I am drawing the line. If I want to draw a straight line and I don't want it to give me the segmented lines, I can turn the node spacing off on the left side, and then it will let me draw straight lines. And you'll notice that when I do straight lines, there's only one line segment. It's all quilt path needs. So if you see a bunch of segments, then you have your node spacing on. It's kind of like a stitch regulator. It's going to drop those nodes every time it needs to make a curve. The lower the number is on your node spacing, the more nodes it's going to put on what you draw. The higher the number is, the fewer nodes it's going to put on. And basically what a node is it is the start and the end point of a line. So you have a little red dot on both the start, stop, and the end, just like you do on the straight line I drew. And they're going to be on top of each other for the next line. So it's going to draw the first line, mark the end point, mark the stop or the start point for the second line, and keep going. And typically the start point is on top of the end point for the line it drew. And that's important when you start editing and pulling things apart, understanding how many lines you need to pull off to get down to the line you want to manipulate. You can also draw curvy lines by using a spline. So if I clear my screen, I'm going to go ahead and draw a line, and I want to use Snap to Grid just so that I draw a, I want to use Snap to Grid and I want to turn my node spacing on so that I can draw a perfectly straight line. With node spacing off, it's going to let me pull that line across the screen. If I then do a spline and put it right under it, you're going to notice that they look the same. And they do until I come up to Pattern and choose Edit and Select All. When I select a line, there are no blue boxes on it. When I select a spline, I have two. These boxes are handles that I can grab and move, and I can change the shape of my line, and I can change it into an S-curve, so I can pull things in two directions. So kind of think of a spline as a line with an S. It makes an S, right? So anytime you want to make something that has an S-curve on it, you would use a spline. If we go back to draw and we go to arc and we do the same thing and we pull an arc across and we edit our arc, you're going to notice that you only have one handle on an arc, and it's going to pull part of a circle. It's always going to be geometrically correct that if you put enough of them together, it will form a perfect circle. And it's symmetrical. Okay, so an arc is a symmetrical design, and it's always symmetrical. I can grab this, move my mouse over, and start manipulating the arc from over here on the right. It is still going to pull it centered, right? And that's really the difference between an arc and a parabola. When I go to parabola and I do the same thing, right, and then edit all of them, you're going to notice it too only has one handle, but it's going to let me pull an asymmetrical arc. Okay, so if I pull over to the right, it's going to pull the design to the right as well. If I pull up, it's never going to be that, you know, perfect part of a circle that an arc is either. It is more of a it can be symmetrical. In this case, it is symmetrical. It's the same on both sides, but it's not part of that perfect circle shape. And it would be really hard to get this to form. As a matter of fact, I don't think I can get it to form anything that would be as exact as the one above it. So understanding what the four drawing tools are for, line, spline, arc, and parabola, make it much easier for you to create your own designs and for you to edit other designs.